Yo, thank you, sir, for joining me on this quick tutorial video on how to optimize your Twitter profile like a freaking boss. There's a lot of benefits of doing this. Number one, you get way more followers. Number two, you increase your personal branding exposure. And number three, your tweets get by far more reach and they get more frequency, which means that they are shown more on people's timelines and they get higher search ranks within the Twitter timelines. So let's get to it. Number one, make sure that your name, right, your first and last name, it's the same first and last name that you use on every single other social media platform you use. So for example, my name is Gabriel Villamizar, but ever since I moved to the United States, America, Gabriel sounded like a women's name, like Gabrielle. So I just said, screw it, I'm just gonna be Gabe. And the issue is that I had Gabriel on Twitter, and on LinkedIn I had Gabe, and on Facebook I had Gaby. So by doing so, by not having the same name, first and last name on every single social media platform, you're making it so much harder for the Google search engine to really locate and identify who you really are. Okay, so if you have this exact same first and last name on every single profile, you increase your likelihood of ranking high for your first and last name on the Google search engine results page. And the same follows on the search engines for Twitter, the search engines for LinkedIn, etc. So make sure that first and last name is there. The next step is make sure your Twitter handle, your at Twitter handle, is again your first and last name. If that's taken, well, good luck, just kidding. If that's taken, you want to go last name, first name. If that's also taken, you might want to include a word, maybe your middle initial, or maybe if it fits, include your whole entire middle name. So it's first name, middle name, last name. Again, this is very crucial. So I had a friend who, back at InsideSales.com, a software company, as he joined InsideSales.com, his Twitter handle was at Nimrod69 or something like that. And I'm like, dude, we gotta fix you up. Like, I'm not gonna allow you to be my friend with the Twitter handle so crazy like that. So anyway, we fixed it up. And what's funny is that a lot of you that are hearing this, you might think, oh, I opened my Twitter profile back when I was in high school. Oh, I opened up my Twitter profile because somebody forced me and I never used it. It does not matter. Okay, you are who Google, Twitter, and LinkedIn say you are. So why not display that with your best foot forward and show the whole world who you really are, what you care about? And specifically, if you're using Twitter for B2B social selling, it is a gold mine and you got to take advantage of that. Okay, the next thing is your Twitter bio. Right here, as you can see here, I've indicated that I am the head of B2B marketing at Lucidchart. And I've indicated and tagged at Lucidchart. So if somebody that clicks on Lucidchart is going to take them to the Twitter company page of Lucidchart. So again, I kind of like to imitate and mimic what I have on my LinkedIn profile headline. And I kind of tweak it, modify it, and paste it onto my Twitter bio. So you might want to put your title of where you're at and tag the company that you're currently working with. Now, if the company that you're currently working with doesn't have a Twitter profile, then they might need some help. So I would just go talk to the marketing team and say, hey, do you want me to help you create a company Twitter profile? Or sometimes they have it, but they're not active, so find it. Again, you're gonna increase your reach for yourself and increase your reach for your company. I mean, think about this. If, let's say you work at Jill and Jay's coffee shop, and Jill and Jay's coffee shop has 200 employees. What if all 200 of the employees indicate in their Twitter bio that they work at Jill and Jay's coffee shop, right? That's potential traffic that you can drive through your employees to the company website and to the company Twitter handle. Okay, more website traffic equals more leads equals more pipeline equals more revenue. So the benefits are endless. I'll just stop it there. Next thing you want to put, I like to just include something that I'm passionate about. So I'm passionate about social selling and social media, and I consider myself a practitioner. Okay, and then I also like to, because I've worked with very big companies that I'm very proud of, and I've built their social media teams, or they've had a big influence in my professional life, I like to include those here. So before being at Lucidchart, I indicated that I was at HireVue. Okay, and you can see here, Twitter verified profile, big deal, blah, blah, blah. Next thing, I like to say that I used to be at InsideSales.com. Click on this, bam. And then I also worked at Southwest Airlines. I also indicate that I'm a Mormon. I'm not ashamed of that at all. And I'm a speaker and I'm a startup advisor. So you can say that you're a runner, or let's say you're a vegetarian. Let's say you're an animal lover. Okay, infuse some of your personality into your Twitter bio. It doesn't have to be professional. You can have some professional tips, professional verbiage. You can also have casual verbiage. You can have personality verbiage. Make it unique, make it your own, and make sure that it communicates clearly who you are, what you do, what you've done, and what you're all about. Okay? Again, this might take some time to come up with a good Twitter bio, but it is highly valuable in SEO, in social SEO. Because again, what people search for on Twitter right here, if they search for any of these terms, right, you hope that you will rank on the Twitter search engine results page for these keywords. And it has a lot of value. Next is your Twitter profile picture. Make sure again that your Twitter profile picture is up to date, in Zoom, it's not faded, it's the current one that you've taken probably as of this year, and it's just of you and yourself. I mean, no disrespect to your significant other, no disrespect to anybody else, but this is your Twitter profile. Now, if you want to add here in your banner image or your hero banner, a picture of your family, or a picture of your dog, a picture of your wife, your girlfriend, or boyfriend, or whatever, that's the place to do so. But in your profile picture, you see, as you can see here, as you tweet and you show up on other people's timeline, they will just see your Twitter profile image. So make sure that's of yourself so people can easily identify you. And as an added bonus or extra credit, I highly recommend that you have the same image on every single social media profile. Meaning that if I go to LinkedIn, I'm gonna have the same one. If I go to Facebook, I'm gonna have the same one. Because there's nothing more frustrating that, let's say you connect with, John Smith, or let's say you connect with Mike Jones. And Mike Jones, you find him on Twitter, you're having a good time, you love Mike Jones' tweets. And then you kind of connect the dots and say, wow, if Mike Jones is very good and posts good content on Twitter, he will most likely post good content on LinkedIn. Let's go and find him. Okay? It is super easy if Mike Jones has the same image, because once you search for Mike Jones, you'll recognize the image right away. But if he doesn't, then it's gonna take you a while. It's gonna make you do homework. So it slows down the process and you might give up. Again, for me, what kind of gives it away and what's kind of been my personal branding, and it kind of just happened, I didn't plan this in a specific way or manner, but wearing my backwards hat, I just thought, if people really like my message, if people really like who I am, and if I want to be authentic, an authentic millennial, I'm just going to wear my hat wherever I go. I'm not going to take it off. It's just going to be part of who I am, right? I even interview in my hat. I'm a previous at actually when I was interviewing at Lucidchart, I realized that I didn't take off my hat and I was just wearing a shirt. And I'm like, this is the type of company that I would love to work at. They're not judging me for what I look like. I do understand the value of dressing for success. Anyway, we're going off a tangent here. Let's go back into this. So make sure your profile image is the same. Make sure you indicate the biggest or largest city where you currently live nearby. Now, I live in Provo slash Orem, Utah. Now, who the heck in the world knows who Orem, Utah is, right? So I want to tie myself to the largest city or neighborhood or whatever you want to call it that's closest to where I am. Therefore, that's Salt Lake City, Utah, because people throughout the world or in the United States or stateside know what Salt Lake City is, which is the capital of Salt Lake. So make sure if you live in a neighboring in a neighboring town or city, make sure you add that. Next is you want to add your LinkedIn vanity or customizable URL as your link right here. As you can see, Twitter allows you to add one specific link that you can link back to any other website or profile or whatever you want. I highly recommend that you add your Twitter profile vanity URL. And the way you find that is if you go to your LinkedIn profile and you go to profile right here. So it's HTTPS, www.linkedin.com/in/GabeVMSR. And as a side note, if you haven't secured or claimed your vanity URL or your customizable URL, click on this little gear icon and click on this little pen, and then bam, you can edit it. Now, you can only secure and claim a name that's not taken, so good luck with that. But again, once you have that, you wanna click on edit profile. And again, this is how you make these edits on your profile, and you want to copy and paste that link right there. Next is, again, your hero image. Oh, as another side note, as you upload, as you save these images, right? Let's see how you identify, okay, I want to use this image as my profile image, and I want to use this other image as my hero or banner image. Make sure you secure and save those images as your first and last name. Because when you upload them, right, that also adds value to your SEO, so the search engines can search and kind of classify you as, this is the Gabe VMSR image. This image is related to Gabe VMSR over here, over there, etc. I think that's it, guys. That's again, pretty simple, basic 101 social media, Twitter, SEO optimization. So if you have any questions, hit me up on LinkedIn, hit me up on Twitter. I'm here to help. If you have any requests for any other videos you'd like to make, I'm starting to do these more often. So that's it and that's all. Peace out.